someone take this dog off my hands? Seriously? There's a lot in this city. Hi.
And so, Skyrim's new favorite folk hero chooses to grace us with their presence. The Dragonborn, I presume.
Well, how do you know what I look like?
Burdens of fame weighing you down? Well, don't worry. I assure you, you'll receive no special treatment from me. Burdens of fame weighing you down? Well, don't worry. I assure you, you'll receive no special treatment from me.
Echo over here. So, you're the welcome committee, is that it?
A joker, too!
Nice.
Wonderful! Yet another troublemaker for us to keep an eye on. At least if your attempts at sardonicism weren't quite so... posturing.
Yeah.
Many before you have thought themselves invincible. Above the Thalmor, above the Dominion, above their precious empire and its laws. Its concordats. They now find themselves hanging from trees.
Oh, yeah?
Decrepit husks wasting away amidst near-endless blizzard.
Is that a threat?
Enjoy your stay in this fair city.
So what do the locals think of you?
Not highly of me, I suppose.
Not surprising.
And then again, the feeling is mutual.
Not surprising either. So you're a member of the Thalmor, huh? I've come across your kind.
No, I just wear the uniform for fun.
Oh, a joker, huh?
Yes, of course I am. I'm here to protect the Aldmeri interests in Bruma, and ensure that the terms of the White Gold Concordat are upheld.
Oh, God.
Important, given that we're so close to Skyrim and its rebellious little Nords.
God, you can take your White Gold Concordat and shove it right up... Well, not many Aldmeri in Bruma.
Next, you'll be telling me... My, oh my, not many Guar in Bruma. Scales of Auriel, thanks for telling me that. I'll be sure to tell all my friends. Put up posters, even.
I'll hold you to it. How about we cut out the verbal sparring and have an actual civil conversation?
To hear you speak of civility is somewhat disarming, considering our environs. This city is filled with uncultured louts who I suspect would quickly turn on each other for an ancient bottle of mead.
Truly.
Given that you at least have the vocabulary and mental faculties to understand the concept of civil society, yes, let us speak.
Oh, good. Splendid.
But be quick about it. Disarming lack of incorrigible idiocy aside, you are still not my idea of a scintillating conversationalist.
Oh, like that matters to me. Why the attitude?
I am Altmer. I was born and raised among the wizard lords of Alinor, and now I am posted to a frigid squat filled with brutes and drunkards.
Oh.
That doesn't exactly lend itself to a warm disposition. Does that make things any clearer?
I weep for you. It doesn't justify being so unpleasant.
Nor does ignorance justify obstinance. But that lesson evidently hasn't trickled down to many residents of this frosty backwater. Oh well. I suppose a Khajiit can't change its spots just like that. But yes, to put a long story short, we are all products of our environment, are we not?
I suppose. What are the real goals of the Thalmor and Bruma?
I will put it in simple terms, so perhaps you might understand.
Oh, here we go again.
The Aldmeri Dominion signed an accord with the Empire, known as the White Gold Concordat.
I know.
That accord guarantees the Dominion, and by extension the Thalmor, that Talos worship shall be outlawed.
What does it matter to you anyway?
We are simply here to ensure that the Empire does not renege on that commitment.
You know, that's part of the reason why I joined the Stormcloaks in the first place. I'm not saying it to this guy, I'm just talking to you guys. People should be allowed to worship whoever they want to worship. The end. Tell me a bit about yourself.
No. If anything fruitful is going to come of this conversation, it will not be the sentimental exchange of life stories. Suffice it to say that I am a Thalmor Justiciar operating in Bruma.
My identity outside of that is entirely irrelevant.
Ah, that's nice. Don't you feel guilty about persecuting people because of their beliefs?
Guilt? Why should I feel guilt? I'm a Thalmor Justicia, yes, but the Aldmeri Dominion is not a single consciousness. This empire is a political entity. It has committed untold acts of persecution and genocide in the past. One need only have a cursory knowledge of the Tiber Wars and Imperial history to know this to be true. Tiber Septim, the man-god so many Nords and Imperials love to revere, was himself guilty of the sins you attribute solely to the Dominion. But I digress. I am a soldier of the Thalmor, and I carry out the duties assigned to me by my superiors. If your goal is to make me feel guilty for enforcing dictates which your own Emperor signed into law, then I'm afraid you will enjoy precious little success.
Do you enjoy enforcing the Concordat, then?
I haven't given it very much thought. My enjoyment is irrelevant. I have a role within the Thalmor, and the duties which go along with that.
You probably do enjoy it.
I have fulfilled and will continue to fulfill that which is asked of me to the best of my ability. Again, my enjoyment, or otherwise, is irrelevant.
I disagree. I think it's very relevant. But, good day to you, Armion.
Goodbye.
Oh, look! An infant! How quaint!
Oh! Why so condescending? Calling me an infant? That's a little beyond condescending, I think.
Surely the better question would be, why so patient?
We're not patient.
Because I can tell you in no uncertain terms that you are trying my patience with your primitive blubbering and inane questions. Leave me.
Never. Why does the Empire let you walk around here like you own the place?
Oh, but we practically do. I presume even one such as yourself is aware of the White Gold Concordat, yes?
Of course.
That document guarantees the Thalmor the end of worship of that miserable little man-god the Nords so love to falsely revere, Talos. We need to ensure that this agreement is upheld.
Well, he makes Armion look like a complete gentleman. What do you and Armion do? I know what you do, but I want to hear it in your words.
Hunt down and execute Talos worshippers, keep people in line, and enforce the White Gold Concordat.
Have a horrible day.
See you.
See you, and then he runs off. Wow. So I wonder if anyone's in here now that it's actually daytime. Anyone I can talk to? Anybody in here?
What is it?
Oh, I didn't see you. Didn't I talk to you? Did I talk to her before? In the tavern?
There
can
you
I help
are
you?
Priest Naremus.
Oh, there is
I'm sorry, I didn't know you were looking for me.
There is a downstairs.
That's
good afternoon.
All right, Anisha. Just wanted to ask. How are you faring with your duties?
Well, for today, I tidied up the Undercroft, prepared the shrines for Sundar's service, scrubbed the floors.
Indeed. That's remarkable. I don't even remember asking you the last one.
I aim to please Priest Naremus, both you and Saint Martin.
Well, you certainly are the most devoted acolyte I've ever seen. I'm sure Saint Martin appreciates your service as much as I.
Hi.
Carry on.
Hello.
Hi. Why did you become an acolyte of Saint Martin?
To ask me why I became an acolyte of Saint Martin is to ask why thunder strikes, why rain falls, or why the wolf hunts.
Okay, why does thunder strike?
It is because this is what comes naturally to me.
Okay. Being an acolyte of Saint Martin comes naturally to you? Specifically that?
You seem confused. Allow me to explain further.
Oh, please, please.
We all follow a path through life. We all desperately attempt to influence it to go a certain way, or lead us to a certain destination. others desperately attempt to steer it away from a destination. The amount of influence we can exert upon that path varies, but is invariably limited. In many ways, we must all make the most of what life gives us, and adapt to its trials accordingly. Without boring you with specifics, it would be appropriate to say that my life so far has taught me many lessons of sorrow and grief. I have constantly been set back, and my attempts to change my course have always been met with bitter resistance by the winds of life. It is through St. Martin's example that I truly find my inspiration to become more than I am. It is in this that I am enlightened, and hope to be reborn.
Okay. Well, that's quite a story. Might as well get back to your floor scrubbing then.
Talk to you later.
So she was from the bar.
Can I help you?
The inn?
The cold nips up here in the mountains, but I've always loved how refreshing it is.
Yep, that's her.
Until next time.
Oh, someone here.
Marcius Carvey, Viscount Bruma. The title garners a lot of respect and a fair few privileges. Anyway, how can I help you?
Good for you, buddy.
I am Marcius Carvain, Viscount Bruma, at your service. Have you read my book by any chance?
Hi. Do you mind? I'm having a conversation here. Okay, I'm gonna ignore him then. What is a fight? Yeah, thank you. Good day. What does a Viscount do? I thought it was Viscount? It's pronounced Viscount?
As Viscount, I'm a sort of secondary count, if you will.
Oh.
I deal with a lot of the same duties as the Count, albeit deferring to him. Often, when the Count is busy with other matters, he delegates lesser affairs to me.
Is he a vampire? What's it like being a Viscount?
It's quite interesting. It also affords me a fair amount of respect. Being the Count's second in command is no mean feat.
So, you wrote a book?
Yes, an explorer's guide to Skyrim.
Oh, I've
Very
read it.
Popular in Skyrim.
Yeah.
Seems to turn up in the most unusual of places.
I have indeed read that book. So what's going on in Bruma County?
The usual. Honest citizens, wild animals, bandits. All in one melting pot.
Dog's pushing me.
That and stubborn Talos worshippers. They've always been a risk to Bruma since the Concordat. Old habits die hard.
Great. Yeah, I no longer wish to say anything else to you.
Farewell.
Now where's this guy who was standing in my face? He was quite rude. Rude indeed. Oh god, between his pews and the dog, I can't... Oh, good god, I can't
Hello.
Move. Someone get this dog. Oh my god, it's bounding over pews after me. Alright, I did not see this. This is a chapel hall. I've read those. These are all like minor and standard. Plentiful though. I can't tell when someone's looking at me or not because of the dog. Look, I can just stand here and open the door. More books! Hagiographies of the Saints? Kind of wonder if some of these are books restored from previous Elder Scrolls games that were not included in Skyrim, or if they're just made up new books. Gotta look them up, man. I gotta look them up. I can sleep there? That bed's owned, but this one is not. We lost a dog. I'm smiling. She'll show up in a minute. There's nothing much down here. Sure, the dog's waiting for us. Yep. Yep.
Hmm?
Ed Warren?
Hmm?
What's your story?
I came here from Skyrim. Everything was fine for the most part, although the Nords were never particularly fond of us. Then the Great War happened, and then the White Gold Concordat happened. We were assaulted, beaten and abused by the Nords, even by city guards sometimes. We couldn't live a normal life anymore. So my family and I fled. We came to Cyrodiil, and as it turns out, we weren't the only victims of the Nords' bullheadedness. Eventually, this little slum was established, and we gained a new home.
Slum in Bruma?
I still hope to return to Skyrim someday, but that isn't likely to happen anytime soon. Not with the uproar over the White Gold Concordat. The Nords don't trust elves anymore, especially Altmer. Why did the Thalmor have to ruin everything for the rest of us?
Great voice. So you're not Thalmor?
Do these rags look like Thalmor robes to you?
Nope.
Seems like everyone looks at an Altmer and sees Thalmor. It's attitudes like this that brought this refugee camp into being. Think on that.
Well done.
Farewell.
Excellent voice. The Scripture of St. Martin, Volume 2. Prayers to the Eight... I might have read Prayers to the Eight Divines. Or of the Eight Divines or something.
Hello.
Hello, Ed Warren. Does the Viscount? Wow. Wondering when they're going to be done looking
at How can I help you?
The city? You can't. Take the dog, actually. Alright, let's check out...
For an Argonian down on his luck.
I gave you some.
Please, madam. Just one septim.
I just gave you two septims. Icewind Traders. Hello.
Have you come to learn or just to bother an old collector?
I've come to learn how to bother an old collector.
How do you do?
What's the word around town?
I heard Cetus got a new shipment from Skyrim.
What?
I wonder if he has any new Nordic artifacts.
You said something else.
Greetings,
okay.
Greetings. Welcome to Goodbye. Icewind Traders. If we don't have it, you don't need it.
You sure about that?
How can I help you?
How's business?
Business is always good for a general goods merchant like myself, since I don't rely on any particular thing to draw in sales.
Hmm.
Take poor old Fadal, the butcher, for example. If someone doesn't want meat, he doesn't have a customer.
True.
But me? Someone doesn't want meat. They want silverware. Don't want silverware? How about a potion? And so on and so on and so on.
I see. You are... What's the word? I can't remember. I can't remember the word. Damn it. I hate when that happens. Basically what he said. He doesn't only sell one kind of thing. He's like malleable is sort of in what he can sell. What are your most popular items?
Most things are very popular. The only thing that isn't popular is cutlery.
Oh no? Why is that?
Turns out the Nords aren't all that big on table etiquette.
Yeah, they use forks and spoons and stuff. Especially knives. What do you sell?
Why, my friend, surely the better question is, what don't I sell? I sell anything and everything. Or thereabouts.
Hmm. So what do you have for sale? Specifically.
Let me know if anything catches your eye.
Oh, he doesn't have too much gold either. Yeah, not that great, even arrows. That's pretty sweet. He's got a lot of mage robes. Minor healing? You don't have any... I'll take the potion. Magicka potion. You don't have any better poisons or healing, seriously. A common soul gem with common. I know who to give that to. Didn't think we'd be coming across it so soon. Let's see if you would like to buy any of my staves. Then I'll give you, giving you a little money as well. Staff of fireballs. And I'll basically just give you another one. I'm trying to just get rid of some of this stuff.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. How much for this carpet? I need a gold inlay carpet. Ooh, what you got in the display case? That we need a key for. Oh god. Locking me in all the time. Good day to you. Gotta head back over to the synod here.
Excuse me, but... It is! That's Scruffy! I've been missing him for so long!
Oh, yes.
He ran away. Well, I'm glad he's back.
I had no idea Banus, I didn't realize was a child. I examined Scruffy and he seemed hurt. Why?
Oh, well... Sometimes Dad accidentally bumps into Scruffy or drops things on him. He doesn't mean it. I promise he doesn't. But, well, he's getting old and his eyes aren't so good.
Do you think this is the best home for Scruffy then?
Good? Yes. You have to understand, Scruffy is my dog. He's my best friend and I can't... No! You can't take him away, please!
Chill, chill. Give me some time to think.
Please, stranger, please give me back my Scruffy.
I want to talk to his father.
I'm Banus. My dad is Albeckius. What's your name?
Amethyst.
Stranger, have you seen my dad?
No, I'd like to find him, actually. Where did you see him last?
Dad's a soldier in the Legion.
Wait.
He's always off with them, serving at some fort up in the mountains.
That's not your brother. Okay, I thought I was asking for his father. For some reason I figured you were siblings. He's in the Legion?
That's what my mom told me. She told me that her dad was in the Legion too.
What does he look like?
He's big and tall, with yellow hair.
Where's your mother?
She works at the Duralview Inn. I don't think she likes it there, but she says she has to make ends meet.
Yep.
Whatever that means.
Who's money.
End, and why does he need meat in the first place?
What's your mother's name?
Licinia Ironheart. She told me that she used to be called Licinia Prelius, but then she married Dad.
Hmm. Is your dad there because of the civil war in Skyrim?
Yeah. Grandpa told me it's a soldier's duty, and that I should be proud of him.
Hmm. Where is your grandfather?
At home, I think. We all live in the big house across from the wizards.
Hmm. What's his name? I'm guessing she means the Synod.
Celis Prelius. Mommy says it's a strong imperial name, but I like my name better. It means I have a strong heart.
Hmm.
Mommy must like it better, too, because she uses it even though it makes Grandpa mad.
Huh. Alright, kid. I'm gonna go track down your mother.
Talk to you later.
Okay. I'm not going in, if that's what you're wondering. We just left. Oh, well, there's the house. Okay, well, it's locked. What time is it? Damn, time passes quickly here. Let's get back to the Synod. Kinda wondering who I should... Wait, is it... Is it up here? I didn't go up there, I know that. Oh, Celius... Prelius.
Can I help you?
Do you know where Haran is?
Haran? That awful... Oh, did Licinia send you my way? Forget I said that. No. I haven't heard from him in months. Not since he was called to arms.
Hmm. You don't seem to like Haran very much.
It's that obvious, is it? Well, I don't hate the boy.
But you don't like him
He's
either.
He's a good husband to Licinia, and a good father to Elena. But if I had a son like that... I'd ask the Divines what I had done wrong.
Would you? Why don't you like him?
You might not understand why, but every soldier of the Legion takes an oath. Upon my honor, I do swear undying loyalty to the Emperor, Titus Mede II, and unwavering obedience to the officers of his great empire. May those above judge me, and those below take me. If I fail in my duty,
guessing that's
long live the Emperor! Long live the Empire! Haran said those words, but I could tell he never meant them. He holds Skyrim and his Nord heritage closer to his heart than he ever held the Empire.
Well, he has the right to feel, you know, the way he feels.
Bye.
Bye. Sky is open. Vulture and the hammer. Hi.
This is no place for strangers, my friend. Please leave me to my hearth and my mead.
Sure?
This is no place for strangers, my friend.
Okay.
Please leave me to my hearth and my mead.
If you insist... I gotta find the Synod. I forget where...
Gort's the name, killing's the game.
Oh god. Not that guy again. Oh god, that dog.
The name's Edvia. I work at Northern Arms, the blacksmith. But it's closed right now.
Wow. She's pretty. Hi.
What is it?
Tell me about yourself.
About me? Not really much to tell.
Surely there's something interesting about you. I mean, you certainly look interesting.
Well, okay, there's no easy way to put this, but... My family wants me to marry this diplomat in the Imperial City. They say he's charming and handsome and witty, but I know what they really mean.
He's a politician.
He's rich, and he's going to bring wealth to the family. Wealth and influence. But I don't want money or power. I want someone I love, and he isn't it. Holgard is. But, well, he's proven more than a little resistant. So far.
Holgard, huh?
See you.
See ya. Okay, so this is the cathedral. White Pine Lodge. The Fighters Guild, they're next door. Okay. I have a common... I'm pretty sure that's what he said he wanted. A common soul gem with...
Good to see you again, friend. What can Olalentius do for you?
Are you the one that wanted the common soul gem with common soul?
What is it?
Yeah, here's your filled common soul gem. You sound, like, so happy right now.
Excellent. I'll take that. And you take your coin. A pleasure. Oh, but that poor soul. I hope that whatever you have trapped in there isn't suffering too much. Oh, better go enchant something with this before I lose my composure.
That's a lot of gold. I really made out on that deal. Pretty sure I didn't spend anything near that 750. Kind of wondering now.
Goodbye, friend.
Yeah, it makes me wonder, actually. I've often wondered such things. How is the soul dealing with being inside this gem? And then, when you enchant something with it, the soul is destroyed? Or does the soul then live on in the item that you've made? God. I couldn't get rid of the dog. Snowberries. He's so noisy. Renard?